Good afternoon, dear students. So today we all have Miss Varsha Vinod. So actually she has a student, she was a student of the Study Senior Secondary School. And she has cleared RAS 2018 examination with the rank 73. Yes, rank 73, which is great achievement. Here we have got brilliant opportunity to connect with her, to get some points and strategies with us. So without wasting any much time, I would like to know with the educational background of Miss Varsha. So first of all, ma'am, congratulations for this wonderful achievement.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. So I would like you to spark our students as well, all those aspiring students we have. So ma'am, my first question is, what was your reaction when you first got selected in RAS?
Yes, that was a more obvious question, but like any other aspirant who wants to get succeed in exam, my reaction was similar. I was nervous as well as I was excited for the results. Like we had a rumor that जैसे मार्केट में फैल जाता है कि 13th को रिजल्ट आ जाता
है,
तो 13th ऑफ जुलाई माय रिजल्ट केम एंड इट केम अराउंड 11 o'clock इन द नाइट एंड एवरीवन वाज फीलिंग अ लिटिल स्लीपी. आई वाज नॉट
फीलिंग दैट नर्वस.
यस, आई वाज डेफिनेटली वेरी नर्वस. फ्रॉम मॉर्निंग ऑनवर्ड्स आई वाज वेटिंग फॉर द रिजल्ट एंड व्हेन द रिजल्ट केम आई जस्ट डाउनलोडेड द PDF एंड आई वेंट इन माय रूम अलोन, सॉ माय रोल नंबर एंड चेक्ड इट इन द लिस्ट. And I was in top 100. And that was, I will say, one of the most happiest and greatest moment of my life. And then I just came to my parents and I told them about the result.
So
first of all, the first reaction was we cried. We all three cried.
Aww.
And then my father and mother were more than happy than me.
So what was their reaction and what they have told you? Like,
yeah, my mother was, my mother's statement was, मुझे तो पता था यही रिजल्ट आएगा. She was that confident about me. And my father was in tears. He's a little more emotional. He was in tears. He hugged me and he was far more happy than me.
See, proud father and mother, definitely. Okay, ma'am. So my next question is, Varsha ma'am, tell us about your educational background. As students are with, you know, there is a this thing we can say misconception that, you know, IIMs or you know, IITs are better institutions and they will get good scoring marks from there. So what are those other degrees that you would suggest to our students so that they can apply in grade 10, 11 or even in colleges?
Yeah, about the graduation for,
yes,
the students who are passing out from 12.
Yes, ma'am.
I would say the thing that if you are graduated from these prestigious institutes like IITs, NITs, AIIMS, that is not one of the most important criteria to get selected in these exams.
Absolutely.
Even if you are graduated from a different in university or a good university or institute, that is just fine. You just have to have one graduation, that's it. And about my educational background, from primary till my 12th class, I have been studying in the study hi mera foundation raha hai shuru se. And I, from this platform, I would like to extend my heartiest gratitude to my school for providing me such an excellent foundation. And I'm pleased that I'm getting this platform from my school so that I can interact with other aspiring students of my school and also the future aspirants who will be seeing this video. And in my college, I graduated from Modi University.
Okay.
I did B.Tech from Modi University of Science and Technology. It's in Lakshmanagar, Sikar. And I didn't did post-graduation.
Okay.
I just graduated and
so
then...
you just started preparing for...
Yes. Since I graduated, I came in the preparation for
right. Now, this is very inspiring. So, ma'am, actually, you know, the time management is really very tedious task, we can say. So time efficiency is very, very, you know, important in preparing such exams. So my next question will start with one myth that you need to study for around 18 hours a day, at least in a year. So what do you want to say about that?
I would agree with you that this is totally a myth which surrounds this exam that you have to study for like 18 hours a day.
Right.
Because practically it is not possible for an aspirant to study for 18 hours. Because you need to also relax yourself as well as your mind, I would say, because you need, our mind needs to absorb the things, whatever we are studying.
Absolutely.
That needs to be a
relaxation
definitely. So yes. I used to study for like 10 hours a day, and in between I used to take breaks. So I think for an average student, and as well as any kind of student, 10 hours a day are sufficient. Like for studying for more rigorous hours, and you are just giving quantity over quality, that will not be so, I would say, it will not yield more fruits than just giving quality over quantity.
So ma'am, what kind of timetable do you follow? Or do you follow the timetable very strictly or not?
Yes, ma'am. I would like to say on this that whatever if we want to achieve in life, be it any goal, you need to have a plan for that. You need to have a blueprint as well as a daily schedule of whatever things you are doing on a per day basis. So for that, I also used to, I had timetable and I strictly followed my timetable. And I would like to say in this thing that even if you are achieving 80% of your daily targets, that's more than enough. Because once we make a timetable, we think that we have to follow it.
It becomes difficult for us to stick to that timetable, right?
Yeah. Even if you are like achieving 80% of your daily targets,
that could be enough.
But timetable is necessary.
Absolutely.
You need to manage your time.
Point to be noted.
Because what we have is our time only.
Exactly. Yes. So you are not skipping any days, like off days ho gaya, nahi padha, aisa kuch?
Ma'am, yes, I used to do that. Wo ek har ek normal aspirant ke saath hota bhi
hai. Absolutely.
Like, in a month, I used to give one day that, matlab wo mera break time hi hota tha, kabhi movie dekh li.
Okay.
So, yes. A day I used to give for break time.
In a month.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, what kind of challenges you face when you're preparing for the exam? So, because as we know that people starting giving the advices, you know, so you have, you should have the backup plan. What are you doing? Like, are you going to crack it? So, you need to have the backup plans and all of that thing. So, what?
Ma'am, I would like to say that we should have a backup plan. If you are going for these exams, you should have a backup plan. I was fortunate and I would say I feel grateful that I had the moral as well as financial support of my parents with me. But if you are thinking of having a backup first and then going for these exams, that's also good. But if you need that, if you feel that you do not need backup at, so intensely, then you can just go for the exam.
What happens most of the time that we want to reach that goal. So now when we have the backup plan, it sometimes, you know, we get distracted that, you know, now I can have the backup plan, so I don't want to reach up to that level. So that there is also a point of a distraction comes in our mind.
Yeah. I would say that don't keep two options for yourself. Kabhi hum khud ko do options de sakte hain. Plan A hai, plan B hai. तो प्लान ए नहीं भी होगा तो भी चलेगा, लेकिन प्लान बी है.
यस, दिस चलता है विल नॉट वर्क.
यस मैम, दैट विल डेफिनेटली नॉट सफाइस इन दिस एग्जाम. चलता है वाला एटीट्यूड यहाँ नहीं चलेगा.
सही है. सो मैम, व्हाट आर योर व्यूज अबाउट द सोशल नेटवर्किंग वेबसाइट्स लाइक इंस्टाग्राम, व्हाट्सएप, एंड यू नो देर आर सो मेनी वेबसाइट्स देयर. सो पीपल यूज टू यू नो गेट देयर मोस्ट ऑफ द आवर्स spending on mobile. So have you spent your time in these websites or not?
Yes ma'am, I would say, I would not like, I would say what is the jo sach hai wahi bataungi.
Bilkul
ma'am. Ki I was not there on Facebook. I uninstalled Facebook, and for some point of time, some period of time, I even uninstalled WhatsApp. But I would say that these sites like Instagram as well as YouTube, there are some things which are beneficial for us in exams also. I was there on Instagram. I did uninstall it, and then in Instagram, for instance, I would say that in Instagram there is a page of ethics. We have a subject called ethics in our exam. So one of the educator has made that page. So I used to follow that page. Daily I used to take questions from that. So I would say like these networking sites have their own benefits also.
Absolutely.
If you use them effectively.
Yes, ma'am.
Even YouTube is also having very good benefits. There are many educators who are
discuss about it.
There are many educators who are making very beneficial videos.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. Even the gaming sections is very prominent these days. Kids used to, you know, play the games most of the time.
Yeah. But so, for those things, we have to keep ourselves away from social sites, I would say, because on them you will be just logging your hours on them,
yes,
and you will waste your time.
Absolutely.
You have to use these sites for your own benefit. If you are using them for those things which are not helping us to get a goal, then that will not be beneficial
definitely
for us.
So basically you have picked out all the positive points from these websites, which is great. Right. So moving on to the next question. What is the, you know, importance of repetitive revision? Because attempting the test is very important, and revision again is very important. So you please throw a light on that also.
I would say that revision and the test series are two most important points to keys to crack this exam. Like, revision is very important thing.
Yes, ma'am.
For any exam you need to crack, revision is the key. Even I used to write in front of my table
table.
Yes.
Yeah.
I wrote there revise, because revision is the key. You need to revise things very effectively.
So every day you are revising the things?
No, ma'am. My schedule was like for 1 week I used to study.
Okay.
They were my daily targets.
Right.
And every Sunday I used to keep it for revision.
Sundays for revision.
Yes. And test series, yes, test series play a very important role. You need to give test as much as you're possible.
Yes,
every Sunday I used to revise as well as give the time for test series.
Test assessment is important.
Yes.
Very true. So the next question is, what kind of strategy you follow? For example, for prelims and mains, the questions are very dynamic and static. So also we have to go a little bit higher end.
Mm-hmm.
And to study that, we has to attach with the current affairs. And
yes,
what all sources you use, to editors, magazines, what are your sources of current affairs?
Yes, ma'am, that's definitely true that we have to keep a balance between both static as well as dynamic part. For static portions, I read the NCRTs as well as the standard books which
NCRTs
we follow in the different subjects. And for dynamic portion, I was a daily follower of newspaper. Since coming into this journey, newspaper padhne ki aadat ho gayi thi.
Local newspaper, getting all the details,
yes,
from there.
I used to read one local newspaper, Daily Bhaskar, as well as the Hindu. I used to follow the Hindu also. I will like to say to students also, like since those who passed out from 10th and 11th 12th students, that they can study, they can read, actually they can read newspaper.
Actually,
also,
these 10th and 11th, they should read newspaper,
yes,
on a daily basis.
If they are having this goal of going into the civil services, then
yes,
they should, abhi se ise habit bana leni chahiye. Because newspaper padhne se aap sirf रीडिंग कैपेसिटी ही इम्प्रूव नहीं होती, आपका वोकैब इम्प्रूव हो जाता है
बहुत ज़्यादा,
एज वेल एज आपको मल्टी डायमेंशन मिल जाते हैं बहुत सारे. लाइक अगर एक टेंथ का स्टूडेंट है, इस बार सिविल लाइक इन हिस्ट्री, अगर वो सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट पढ़ गया,
ओके,
या फिर पॉलिटी में उन्होंने प्रीएम्बल पढ़ लिया, एंड देन यू आर रीडिंग अ न्यूज़पेपर और कभी कोई न्यूज़ आ गई लाइक रिलेटेड टू प्रीएम्बल, तो दे वुड गेट अ न्यू पर्सपेक्टिव ओवर दैट.
Definitely.
So I think students को newspaper पढ़ने की भी आदत होनी चाहिए.
Right, ma'am. Right. I agree. So, ma'am, what kind of strategies you followed for the prelims and mains? Because what are the variations students should learn if he plans to go for a civil services? So, what is, you know, right from the school time and from the schedule making, what he should or she should follow?
Yes, ma'am. About the strategy, I would say first thing is we should make a timetable. Before diving into the exam, just go through the syllabus of the exam, what the exam is demanding from us. If
which is very fast.
Yes,
fast.
Yes, like it is a ek kahawat bhi hai ki all under the sun exam mein aata hai. But aisa nahi hai. Uske liye do key hai, syllabus and previous year paper.
Okay.
If first you should go through that.
Right.
Dekhiye exam demand kya kar raha hai, syllabus kya hai, and uske baad go through all the books, NCRTs. I would say the foundation NCRTs provide, that is the best foundation. NCRTs of 11th and 12th,
yes,
they provide very good foundation.
Okay.
And then you should make your timetable, you should align yourself according to the subjects, according,
yes,
to your timetable, and you should follow that.
Yes. So, Varsha ma'am, nowadays you can see that there are the online studies which have led to a problem, which is very evident. And students in this lockdown have stopped writing practice.
Yes.
They are not writing. So how do you think that these examinations, because writing is very important in these examinations also.
Yes.
So please, can you relate this point to us?
Answer writing is the key to crack this exam.
Yes.
university. If you are what this exam demands is there is a word limit. हमारे पास एक word limit होता है, time limit होती है.
Absolutely.
Within that word limit and time limit, you have to express your opinion over that particular question in that particular frame of time.
So,
you should have an answer writing practice. अगर answer writing practice होती है, तो that involvement उसमें भी we can adjust as well as कम words में कैसे अपनी बात को express करना. वो that is the art that you should know to crack this exam. So I would say वो answer writing practice से ही आता है. And even if students जो सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जाम को भी को अपना गोल बनाते हैं राइट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम फ्रॉम आई थिंक सो आफ्टर 10th स्टैंडर्ड 9th टू 10th स्टैंडर्ड अगर वो इस चीज को आदत में बना लेते हैं अपनी आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस को तो वो आगे दैट विल बी वेरी बेनिफिशियल फॉर देम. आई रिमेंबर द टाइम ऑफ माई स्कूल लाइक इन 9th और 10th आर हिस्ट्री टीचर सॉरी एसएसटी टीचर सोशल साइंस टीचर यूज्ड टू फोकस ऑन दिस थिंग दैट राइटिंग पॉइंट्स write the answers in points.
Same, so, I also used to tell my students, being an SST teacher, I always used to tell, please to students, you have to have the writing practice, which is key.
Yes, definitely.
So, as you mentioned.
Aapko, if you are writing concisely,
yes,
and you are writing in points, then you are making the work of examiner also easy.
Very
so, he will award you with good marks, I would say. So, try to write in points, and try to write whatever is needed.
Yes.
So, these all things we learn in school. So answer writing practice helps you that.
Yes. So, okay, moving on to my last question. Ma'am, actually, would be that some students are always worried about the question which are being asked in the interview session. So, it is very tricky, you know, when they used to hesitate that what kind of the, you know, questions are being asked. So, what do you say about that?
I'll say interview is more like RPSC has also given the term for it has not used the term interview, it has used the term personality test. So it is more kind of your test of your personality. They will evaluate you, like whether you are morally upright, whether you are good as an administrator.
Okay.
So these things, these all come up automatically out of your personality in that 25 to 30 minutes
so
of time.
So we can't period. Have a like a preparation sort of a thing, it comes naturally.
It will come naturally, right? Yeah, I would say. I have faced interview 2 times
yes,
and I know कितना भी prepare कर लो आप 5-10 minutes के बाद ऐसा environment create हो जाता है room में कि you become natural whatever you are
is yourself.
Yes. So interview I don't think there's no need to fear for that interview. It's very natural. They will make you like at ease.
Okay.
The exam interviewers they make you at ease.
Yes, ma'am.
And it's very, I would say, that's very gradual and easy going process. No need to worry for the interview.
So at the last, I would like you to ask, you know, inspire our students with your words.
Okay, so I would like to say a few lines of late Honorable APJ Abdul Kalam sir. He used to say that earlier the world was driven by muscle power. Then came money power. But now the world is driven by the power of knowledge. And that is the motto of the study school also. I know that knowledge is power.
Yes.
So students and all the aspirants, if you have to make yourself strong, you have to make our nation strong, then focus on this knowledge part, that knowledge is power. Focus on education. And I think that we are born in those times where we are lucky enough to be born in these times where we can choose our career. And there are no such limitations. So just follow your heart, follow your passion, and be sincere and disciplined towards your passion. You will definitely achieve it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Varsha, for such an inspiring our students as well as us. Thank you so much.
Thank you.